Hey, what's up? My name's Gwen, and that is Tony. That's Adrian. That's Tom Dumont. And we are in a band called No Doubt.
They're one of the hottest rock bands on the planet.
Human beings love to be adored. Nothing sucks about that.
Now, a rare look at what really goes on in their world.
You're gonna edit out the F words and all that, right?
On the road with you too. And in Jamaica, recording rock steady.
Damn, that was so much fun.
Find out what happens off stage.
Good times. Good times.
Why Gwen is glowing.
I didn't know I was gonna feel like this. I didn't know I wanted it so bad.
And how the band tackles the tough questions.
Is it possible to have a meaningful relationship, or is your meaningful relationship No Doubt?
Wow.
Getting to know the real No Doubt.
I've been a rock and roll slut at times, and that was fun.
Next on Deeper With.
1, 2, 3, No!
To play the first night here in Oakland. We flew in at 6:45, and we go on stage at 7:30.
We had this police escort. It was like all you two and all of us, and it was all these cars. And it was crazy. Like, we were going through red lights.
It literally took like 2 minutes to get from the airport to the venue.
Like, the whole city was stopping for you two, and we were like tagging along going,
the beer. We're going to be sitting on this thing for a long time.
I love being on a tour bus. My space consists of a coffin kind of bed, and that's the only real space that's your own.
It's sort of like camp.
Yeah, it's totally like camp.
A little bit.
It's like, what was that? It's like sixth grade camp for, you know, 30-somethings.
For me, one of the favorite moments is when we all get on the tour bus and we all like hang out and talk, and those guys make me laugh.
Are there bathroom rules on a bus?
Yeah, there are bathroom rules. On a tour bus, you're not supposed to take a shit on it because it clogs the whole system.
After 15 years of being with the same people, it's exactly like having another family.
I do this thing called the bag of shame, where if we're in the middle of nowhere and I have to go really bad, I take a plastic trash bag, put it over the over the toilet, go in the plastic bag, and then just, you know, put it aside till we get to a town, then I can take it and put it in the trash.
Are you guys a family? Are you another whole family unit, you know,
Absolutely.
Dad?
Absolutely.
Tom would be the dad.
My friends Jack and Jack. Always on the bus.
I suppose at this point, Gwen and I would be brother and sister.
Hey, did you go see my newest picture inside this magazine that I got since my surgery? I think I look better now since I had the surgery.
Wow, good job.
Yeah.
And Adrian would be like the younger crazy brother.
Mexican food is my favorite food.
Plus, it makes a lot of funny, stinky, loud farts. Those are always funny.
It's kind of like being in a traveling circus and you're with your best friends and you get to just hang out all day long, and then you get to play shows, which is really fun.
When you get to the venue, what happens?
It's totally different than a No Doubt like tour situation. It's a little more spontaneous, a little more crazy. You never know what's going to happen.
You're the hardcore fan. Right there. Tony, come say hi.
U2 stage lives, that we get to bond for 45 minutes every night.
Who would have ever dreamed that I would sing with U2? Ever. Okay, this is the actual heart that Bono performs on every night.
And you come out here and just kind of check it out?
I've never been on here. This is my first time. Because this is their show. Mm-hmm. We're opening, and this is their part of their whole thing. So I would come out on the heart and like use it and like ruin it. You know what I mean? Like,
sure.
It's like respect. But I've never been on it. So I thought I should come on at least one time before. So that's good.
These guys have set the standard of being a rock band. absolutely the most incredible experience, not only to be able to open for them every night, but to go watch them every night.
We're watching it and Bono's like singing, and he sees us. And he, like, imagine that we were, like, down there. And he sees us, and he sees us coming, and he goes, he's like, da-da-da, and he gets down like this. And he lays like this and starts singing to us. And like holding our hand and stuff, and I was like, this is not happening to me right now. Bono's singing to me, I'm so embarrassed in front of the entire, I was embarrassed, yet I was, how do you say it, elated.
What do you guys want to do?
One more song.
One more, guys.
I love opening up. I think opening up is just like, probably, I don't know, there's something really challenging about it, because you know that the audience isn't really there for you, but you know that if you are good enough, you can win them over, and that's super fun.
The loud guy.
We're going to the dressing room. I don't know about you.
This is so glamorous.
Compared to the club days, this is really glamorous. Super, super, duper glamorous.
There's all this stuff, there's the candles and the lights and the smells and the saris. Do they make a difference to you?
Yeah, it's definitely an important part. And I think we've earned it, you know, like, I did all the years getting ready in the van and saving every diamond that I put on my face because I couldn't buy a new one. So now when I like use bobby pins and stuff, I just like throw them away afterwards.
That's your yeah. Minor luxury.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm gonna use 15 cotton balls right now, you know.
Okay, honey, how do those stay on when you're on stage? Because you're all over the place.
Well, because I wear these on top of my shirt.
Okay.
I don't just go like bare girl.
Just checking.
Yeah, plus I don't have a lot of, I'm like a 12-year-old girl for the rest of my life.
With the dressing rooms, when we're playing at bigger places, I get my own space so that I don't have to get naked in front of everyone, which is nice. But I love them. Like, I'll have my own dressing room, but I'll spend all my time in their dressing room, you know. I'll get ready and then I'll go over there and hang out because I need the vibe, you know.
You guys get the fancy dressing room.
Yes, this is my outfit.
Is it hard to find your own individuality on the road when you're so much part of No Doubt, the band?
This is everything. Like, I want to be with those guys. I want to be hanging out with them. Mm-hmm. Get used to it, so not being with them is weird, you know?
So that's where you're wearing that little guy?
Yeah, and underneath.
Oh, he's special.
It's a special little treat. It's my little tuxedo. No. I guess there's no better time than the present to put it on, huh?
Yeah, I'm not going to watch, but
it's cool. I can't watch either. I'm a nice girl from the suburbs.
Sense of humor in this band is essential. Without it, we would do it.
Look at your little hiney.
Yeah.
We have nothing better to do but make jokes, talk and basically become sixth graders. That's what keeps us going, for sure.
You know, Velcro for easy access.
Yeah.
Do you miss having other girls around on tour? You're out here with, they're funny and they're cute. And
they're rad.
They're a little smelly
but
sometimes.
Yeah. But. I definitely feel like I've missed out a little bit on that whole girl gang thing. But to be honest, I've always been a one-on-one kind of person anyways, like besides these guys, you know, we're like a pack.
Coming up, confessions of a naked drummer.
Your penchant for taking your clothes off.
Male nudity, always funny.
The trouble with recording in paradise.
Sometimes when you're in Jamaica, they give you this thing called rum.
Rum.
And Gwen gets personal.
I went in the doctor and they were like, you can freeze your eggs. I was like, what?
I just listened to the board tape from last night and I was singing Don't Speak and it's like all, you and me used to be together. I'm like, what?
It's in some key.
I thought I was really singing it on last night too. Well, surprised me. I do everything myself. Nobody tells me what to do ever.
The amazing thing about Gwen, I think, for all of us, is that we've seen her grow as a person and as a songwriter, a lyricist, and as a performer in the last 5 or 6 years. Like, it's amazing to see how far she's come.
Hell yeah.
It's kind of fun.
Tom is kind of like the support in the band, and he's very inspiring with what he does come up with.
What do you think for tonight?
But Tom also is, he's blossomed a lot. You know, he's blossomed into quite a party animal.
Yeah! Yes, hair, hair.
Adrian makes sure we rock.
Black lipstick.
And that we don't kind of wimp out too much.
This is when Tony does kind of a funny ritual. At this point,
okay, you guys.
He takes his shirt off.
Everyone needs to put their hands out.
Tony is the leader on many levels. He's on top of everything. He makes sure this ship runs really tight. He basically keeps everything together. He's definitely the glue.
All right, away we go.
Final thoughts before you go on stage.
Oh, so excited.
Yeah.
You know what? No matter how weird the day is and like the stuff that you have to do every day, everything seems to come together when we get back up, when we get on stage, like right away. It always seems to come together. Allison,
yep.
Come in here.
Join them.
Oh, I get to be in? Right on.
Tom, what's your hair doing tonight?
You just woke up. It was unstable.
That's something about Mary.
It looks
right
so
there.
Good.
And let's have a great time.
All right. Yeah. One, two, three. No!
You rule, dude.
I live for playing live. Like, that's my favorite thing about being in the band, getting on stage. And when you have a good show, there's absolutely nothing better in the world. Just being together and making it work together and just connecting on such a crazy level.
Such an awesome thing writing songs and creating music. It's just like, it's such a mystery. You never really figure it out. About usually the problems or the good things, and that usually has to do with your relationship. And for me, I mean, songs, sex, love, it all is one thing, and music, it all ends up in the same place for me. People say, oh, you give so much to yourself, is it weird, da da da, but it's one song, and it's one moment and one thought in my head that I expand on.
What do you get out of performing live?
Human beings love to be adored. When we were playing in front of thousands of people, we were being adored. Nothing sucks about that at all.
Coming off stage, I have to be with them because everyone always has a different experience.
That was a great show. It's like no pressure. We're kind of opening up for the main act, so for us it was just like have fun up there. And it came together pretty well. And now we get to go watch you too. It's the best part of the night. It's so inspiring to us to see how they all get along and work together, and they understand their roles in the band. But when they get on stage, they're so much bigger than, you know, the sum of their four parts. It's this amazing force that hits everybody.
From when I was a little kid. I mean, this is the first time I've ever seen them was on this tour, and it's a big deal.
Did you say something on stage?
What's that?
He said, did you hear him?
No.
Did you guys hear what Bono said? He said, right, Tony? He goes, right, Tony?
What song was that, dude? It was real?
Look at
yes, it was totally real.
It was real.
And after you two, what did you guys go home, go to bed? You go out and play?
No. We go out. And I think you guys are going to go with us, so it'll be kind of fun. It could be a late night.
Normally, do you guys go out every night?
The guys go out every night.
Time to go back to the hotel, get our drink on.
I like going out, but I like to get ready, and I like to go out, see what I'm missing, and then go home.
Good times.
I get tired by the end of the day, and my voice gets tired, and that's just me, you know? But they really enjoy it, and they really have fun.
As the years have gone on, I don't know what it is, but it's like every day's a party, or it can be.
You know what the best part about all of the rock and roll glamour is not waiting in line for anything.
Look, that guy's letting us in right now.
Yes, I am.
Lines suck, and I'm glad I don't have to wait in them.
Your penchant for taking your clothes off.
Male nudity, always funny. Once I did it, my band was laughing so hard and the audience was so entertained that I couldn't stop it. I'm still not stopping it.
Well, they intercepted my cocktail because we're on the way to the next bar.
Coming up, find out why Tom doesn't get to name the albums.
My idea for the album is going to be called Up Your Ass and Around the Corner. It's got a ring to it, everybody knows it.
Plus, why Gwen took a shot at rock star romance.
I would never go out with a rock star. Like, that to me is, like, disgusting. But I met this guy, and something just happened. It was like, you know, Cupid. Didn't have a choice.
And how that love affair changed the dynamics of No Doubt.
There was a period in time when all of us didn't really know how to deal with the fact that she was dating, you know, somebody in another band.
Hey, what's up? My name's Gwen, and that is Tony. That's Adrian. That's Tom Dumont. And we are in a band called No Doubt. And you are not in Jamaica, and we are. When we toured on Return of Saturn, we spent like every day after the show, the boys set up this room and they had like this dance hall party.
We decided that maybe the good thing to do would be to come to the source of where dance hall music is from and work with the best dance hall producers we can find.
It was just an idea we had. We're like, let's try and record some of this stuff in Jamaica.
We wanted to come and see, you know, where it all started and, you know, try to absorb some of the vibes.
So here we are. It's a miracle.
Titles for the album. The first one I came up with was Hella Good, which Tony hates. And the second one I was thinking of, I wanted to call it Just Dance. And then the third one, which just came up today, was called Rocksteady. It's my favorite one right now. No Doubt Rocksteady.
My idea for the album is going to be called Up Your Ass and Around the Corner. It's got a ring to it, everybody knows it.
Today we're making a trip to Kingston to record some guest Jamaican artists on our music, Bounty Killer and Lady Saw.
Lady Saw is like this DJ here in Jamaica who's really hardcore. She just came up with lyrics right on the spot, you know. I just went in there and sang, it was really good. After 14 years, you kind of build up all these rules and laws about the group, you know, and it's all stuff we made up. And I think we all looked at each other and said, if we're going to make another record, we got to kind of like let go of all that.
Bring him in the second chorus, then let him do the bridge, and then go out with the song.
More underground dance, I think.
Instead of being so precious about getting all the sounds just perfect and all just the right gear, it's just like, you know what, throw up the mics, press play, and jam.
Is that the difference in when you were writing Return of Saturn to writing Rocksteady, just lyrically and in terms of their whole vibe, it's night and day.
I took the idea of writing that last record very seriously, and I think that in some ways it was a good learning phase to go through, but it's kind of not what No Doubt's about.
Damn, that was so much fun because it sounds great in there.
Rocksteady was going to be fun. And it was going to be about the process. And it wasn't going to be about any kind of restrictions.
I know how to make you laugh.
It was going to be about freedom.
So good.
We've had 3 power outages during the recording of these songs here. And one of them was at night.
I've got a boyfriend, he's in love with me.
So flashlights come out and we just kind of hung out.
I like the fireflies.
Yeah.
Cruising around.
Let's see.
No.
Oh, that is disgusting. But amazing.
That wasn't thought it would be a catastrophe. Everyone going, oh my God, we're losing so much money in the studio and blah, 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 blah. But here it's like, you know, whatever. We'll take a break, have some beers, and go back to recording. It's mellow. We're actually living all on the property right now where the recording studio is, and it's amazing because the jungle basically meets the ocean. We have an amazing view, food is great, and we're totally isolated, so there's no distractions at all.
Everyone I've asked about the Jamaica recording sessions doesn't tell me about the recording session. They tell me about Jamaica. Why is that? What happened there with you guys?
It's so funny. It was like a blur. It was just so much fun.
Sometimes when you're in Jamaica, they give you this thing called rum.
Rum.
And there was so much stuff to do in this 2 weeks, but we managed to pull it off, even with all the distractions.
We get this great Jamaican breakfast every morning.
I dare you to eat one huge scoop of that in your mouth.
No way.
I'll totally give you $20 right now.
No way. $500 US, not even worth.
And then we go down to the Blue Lagoon and we swim.
We'd end up spending the whole afternoon, you know, 5-6 hours in the sun, and we had so much fun together.
During the whole 14 years, we've never recorded outside of California, which is kind of crazy, you know? It's inspirational just being able to go out every day, sunbathe, and just feel the island, and then come back here and take that energy that we capture and translate it into music. It's a beautiful thing.
Hey, baby, hey, baby, hey.
Hey, baby, hey, baby, hey. Boy, say, hey, baby, hey.
Tony's a star on this record because he was the most free on Rocksteady that he's ever been.
First one you said was E, right?
No. Tony, you're punching it too hard.
To see my best friend hold that kind of like torch of creativity in the band is so inspiring for me. And I think that that really was what made this record great.
Yeah!
Why could you be free with this record as opposed to other records? What were you like before?
I think that I've always been really concerned about everything on all levels, like business and music and the way we present ourselves.
He can be really a worrier, you know, and he worries about things, and he doesn't really live in the moment so much because he's concerned about what might happen or what did happen and this and that. And he's kind of grown out of that, which is just so exciting to see.
There's so many options. So awesome.
It's really...
And the bridge is amazing. That groove that goes... I just felt like if I let go, we'd be able to take it to another creative place, and that's kind of what happened. It actually did work. You know, you read all these books, and you hear about people who just let go of things, and you start worrying about things, and you just let, like, the energy flow through you, and as cheesy and cliche as it sounds, it really does feel like that happened. Amazing.
Me and these guys are on such an amazing, like, high.
I think we're at the best place we've ever been as a band, and the way we get along and the chemistry between us and the way we made this record this year and how easy it was and how it kind of just flowed out of us. It's hard for me to be objective about stuff, but this record I just feel like we really nailed it.
Oh, Shiva!
Shiva!
Coming up, a peek at the next generation of No Doubt.
A little Adrian who's going to someday either be a basketball player or a drummer and hopefully wear more clothes than his father.
Gwen talks about one of her greatest fears.
I don't know why I always get scared that I won't be able to, because to me that would be like devastating.
And why the rock star life isn't all it's cracked up to be.
I found it really tough to have a serious relationship while I'm on the road, but I'm still looking.
I got engaged on New Year's Day. Can you believe it? I can't believe it. It's weird. I feel so different now. I feel like reborn, or like I have a whole new life ahead of me. I didn't know I was going to feel like this. I didn't know I wanted it so bad. You know, it's pretty cool.
My name is Gavin Rostell, and this is my friend Gwen.
Going out with a rock star, hard thing to do?
I would never go out with a rock star. Like, that to me is like disgusting, you know what I mean? Like, that was my attitude, you know what I mean? Because I live with those boys and I know what they're like. I am behind the scenes, like I know exactly what goes on. But I don't know what happened, I just, Tony and I split up and I met this guy and something just happened. It was like, you know, Cupid. Didn't have a choice, and I just thought I kind of fell for him.
Hey, what's up?
I admit he's hot as hell, and he looks really good all the time, but just a normal guy, you know? He's not a normal guy. He's a special guy.
When you were making Rocksteady in Jamaica, mm-hmm. Gavin came on down and visited. Do you lose focus when this cute guy's around?
He almost wasn't going to be able to come for some reason, and I was like, you have to come, this is it. Because a lot of times we miss out on each other's big moments.
In the past, you know, they've been touring at different times, they can't get together, so you can see how tough it is for them, you know, and how much strain it can put on a relationship.
The one thing that I do learn every time when I'm like, we're apart from each other, and I get really used to my, like, life, and then he comes back in, is that he does balance me out, you know, and he does give me that thing that I need that I don't realize I need sometimes, you know.
This is the missing part of the whole week so far.
I deliver magazines around the world. So I go on planes and I bring music magazines.
She actually had time to spend with her boyfriend. I think that put her in a great headspace to write the kind of lyrics she wrote on this record. Very happy and upbeat lyrics, you know.
Had a very public breakup with your boyfriend who you see, Tony, every day. You have a very public relationship with your current boyfriend. Is there ever tension that way, having these two important men in your life still?
I would admit it's a strange situation, and I would have never, like, dreamed that it could work out. I respect him being to be able to, like, put up with the situation because it's so strange.
There was a period in time when all of us didn't really know how to deal with the fact that she was dating, you know, somebody in another band.
Somehow, Tony and I were able, because I guess the passion for the band and the music and our friendship, we were able to make it work out somehow.
Gwen is still my best friend, so we talk about stuff every day. And luckily, we weren't like 19 or 20. We were in our mid-20s, so we had 8 or 9 years behind us already as a band.
Come on, Tony!
And you're cool with it. You feel good about it.
I feel great about it. I feel very lucky because I wouldn't imagine if I had to give up one in my life, I wouldn't be able to, you know. I can't give up my family, which is Tony and my band, and I can't give up this guy that I found in my life that has just, that balances me out. It makes me feel good.
I think the longer we're together, none of that stuff matters. What matters is that we're getting along, enjoying the process, and making music that we want to make.
Everyone has described you as the leader of the band. How do you feel about that responsibility?
That's a weird one, because I really feel like we're such a democracy.
He is always working on No Doubt, and he has such a passion for it.
He's the one who includes everybody, makes sure this is a band effort, it's not an individual effort.
This is Stephen Bradley and Mr. Gabriel McNair. Without these two guys, we pretty much suck on stage live, so thanks to them, we pull it together.
The band is very precious to me because it's all I have. It's everything I have in this world, and I've spent 15 years doing this, so I don't really have other stuff that I go and do on the side.
See, he's the caring one, right? He makes sure that he has stickers in his thing in case he needs to give them to somebody.
If he wasn't the way he was, this band would not be together 2 years, let alone 15.
Is it possible to have a meaningful relationship, or is your meaningful relationship No Doubt?
You know, not to make excuses, but I'm concentrating on what's ahead of us in the next year, which is touring quite a bit and stuff like that. And I found it really tough to have a serious relationship while I'm on the road. I think it's just different for everybody, you know, and the rest of my band has managed to pull it off, but I'm still looking.
Are you going to have a family of your own?
I hope that I get blessed with one, you know? I mean, at some point, even if I can't have children, or I don't know why, I always get scared that I won't be able to, because
really?
To me, that would be, like, devastating.
As one woman in my 30s to another woman in her early 30s, do you think about timing? I mean...
Of course I do. It's so weird. I went to the, you know, you have to go to the doctor to get checked up if you're a girl. Like, you always have
yes,
to
you
go.
Do.
It's the worst horrible experience of your life. But I went in the doctor, and they were like, you can freeze your eggs. I was like, what? I was at the point where I couldn't believe I was walking out of that room and they were saying that I had to be concerned, you know what I mean? But I want to have children for sure.
So that balance of career and motherhood is a concern for you, yeah?
Yeah, it has been for a while, actually, and I want to be a good parent. I want to do it right and do it good, and I'm super self-obsessed and absorbed in this career. Like, I love it so much. I'm having so much fun that I don't see how that I would be able to be a responsible parent at this point, but we'll see, you know? I want to do it really badly, because I think the idea of two people that decide to commit to each other for life and then they come together and have a child together and raise that kid together is probably the most romantic thing that you could do. I mean, I can't really think of anything else that's more romantic.
What would people be surprised to know about you?
By the way, look at this beautiful, beautiful belly.
I think that because I'm the first one having a baby and the first one to be married, I think that's the most surprising of all.
You've got a rock and roll wife.
She's my hero. Oh my God.
Nina, Adrian's wife, she was our assistant. Like, she's the one that took care of us. Then Adrian stole her and married her. And got her pregnant.
He's grinding his teeth right now to a drum beat. And he's having me guess what song it is.
And I admire Nina, Adrian's wife, for getting pregnant. Because we were in Jamaica and we were making this record. And we were laying on the raft at the Blue Lagoon saying, okay. So we'll finish the record, we'll come out this year, and then next summer we're gonna both get pregnant, and then that's it, we're doing it. And she calls up, I'm pregnant. I'm like, oh, you totally screwed me, dude. Or screwed him.
A little Adrian who's gonna someday either be a basketball player or a drummer and
or
hopefully
naked.
Wear more clothes than his father.
Is there something that you don't want your kids to know about your rock and roll past?
Nah.
It's all gonna be out there.
I have nothing to hide.
I'd been a rock and roll slut at times, and that was fun. If I didn't know her, I might still be a rock and roll slut. I don't know.
What's something that you're proud of that you'll brag to your kid?
Yeah, is it going to be, look at your dad, he's in a G-string, he looks like an idiot. No, probably not that. The important thing is going to be that we were committed to each other for 15 years or however long it lasts, and that's very rare in rock music, and that's important in life, and I'm definitely going to make sure that he understands that.
Tell us about the douche.
Oh, the douche.
There's actually Tom, and then there's douche.
It had nothing to do with douching.
Douche is his alter ego.
You're going to edit out the F words and all that, right?
In normal life, I'm really, you know, mild-mannered and quiet. They scream my name.
You have a lot more fans than you think.
I do have a lot. But maybe it was the guy on the other side of me, his name was Tom.
Sometimes when I drink a little bit, my personality changes.
Anybody know where we're going? Tom, do you mind? Do you know where we're going?
Beware, it's a Jekyll and Hyde thing, for sure. When the douche comes out, all hell breaks loose.
This is different.
Coming up, the perks that make Gwen more than just a girl.
Oh my gosh, free makeup, you know? Like, you just can't get enough of it. Like, I'm sorry, but I love it still.
And Tony explains why no doubt, have no regrets.
It's really, really hard to say what's going to happen next, but I'm not worried about it at all because we've had such a beautiful history together.
We're doing a
doing an interview for people to see what they think about the band called No Doubt. Have you ever heard of them
before? Oh, I love No Doubt. No Doubt.
Are they kind of dorks, though, a little bit? Not very cool.
Sometimes the head chick is.
Oh, cool. What do you think? Have you heard of them before?
Yeah, I have.
You have?
I have. I like the girl. I forget her name, but I like the girl.
She's kind of a geek, though, don't you think?
No, she's kind of cool. Like, she looks good with Eve.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, she grows on you after
right.
a while.
Thank you.
Welcome to your room. Wow. You already packed it?
Yeah.
I'm pretty much spoiled rotten.
What's great about being Gwen Stefani of No Doubt?
I have an amazing life. It's very glamorous. You know, they say, everyone goes, it's not, you know, they don't know, it's not that glamorous. It is glamorous. I mean, there's so many fun things that we get to do.
How about some of the more frivolous stuff, the clothes, the hair?
Oh my gosh, free makeup, you know, like you just can't get enough of it. Like, I'm sorry, but I love it still. Like, I don't ever get like oh, another thing of free makeup, but I don't get tired of it, you know?
Jeez, just putting on my lipstick.
The trappings are great and getting treated very well wherever you go, and you get used to a certain comfort level.
I'm trying not to do anything myself. Uh-huh. If I could just sit here on this chair and play my bass from here,
that's a long time.
I think just the fact that this is our job and this is what we do, and it's still a little bit unbelievable. I play the game right from the start. It was 1995 when we all actually got to quit our jobs. I was five classes away from graduating with a degree in psychology at Cal State Fullerton, and then we went on the road for Tragic Kingdom. We definitely expected to have to go back. We were going to go back and resume our old jobs if they were still available.
I never thought that we would even get on the radio or make a record or any of that stuff.
I think in 1996 is when we realized, like, wow, this is real. This might be it.
Why do you think you've been together 15 years?
It's a long time. It's so long. It's like half my life. We like each other. I don't know.
Bono said this really cool thing. He said, they're a band based on love and friendship, much like ourselves. And I think that's what it is. Like, we really do get along well with each other, and we like to hang out with each other.
It's so easy, you know, for bands to break up and implode from all the pressure, but we just have the right chemistry and the right personalities that it works.
Bandmates, nice to see you guys.
Gwen
Stefani.
Hey, what's up?
Gwen Stefani, nice to meet you.
We're around each other for 12 hours a day, and we love each other, we deal with each other, we have respect for each other, and I think that's what makes a family.
Have all the sacrifices been worth it, as far as you're concerned?
There's a lot of sacrifices that we've made that don't even feel like sacrifices because you just do it because you want to. It takes that kind of energy to make it work. I mean, it's like we're married to each other. And, like, it has to be the number one thing. That's why now that Adrian got married and now that we have a little baby coming along, things are going to change a little bit, you know?
So funny you say we're having a baby.
Well, because...
No Doubt's having a baby.
We're having a baby.
I think things are definitely going to change and priorities are going to change. That's going to be the first time that anyone in the band's had a child, you know, which is pretty remarkable considering, you know, we're in a rock band and we're in our early 30s.
Are you going to take any time off from the band to just go on paternity leave, so to speak?
There is a paternity leave for No Doubt.
The No Doubt baby lamb chop in there.
Everyone said, no, we'll just stop. And I said, no, it's too important, and do it without me, and I'll hire somebody and keep it going.
She didn't come. Baby brewing sometimes creates heartburn.
Adrian obviously needs to be there for that. And. We want him to be there for that.
Have you guys ever split up like that before?
First time in 14 years.
Now that's got to be a little scary.
Not too scary. I mean, what's more important, family and baby or rock and roll? Rock and roll's pretty important, but not that important.
Your youth
what you think about where No Doubt is right now.
I think that we've already gone through all the growing pains, and now we're at a place where it's just all about having fun and enjoying the moment.
We're really aware of the fact that what we get to do can go away really quickly. You know what I mean? We've seen, you know, plenty of behind the musics and shows to see how, you know, fame comes and goes.
Is this a forever thing? Is No Doubt forever for you?
We don't think about the future anymore, which is so cool to be in that space where you don't have to really worry about it. You can just live in the moment, and that's what Rocksteady is all about.
It feels pretty exciting. It feels good. We're definitely having a good time. You know, things that have happened to us are pretty extraordinary, and you know, we'll never forget it.
It's really, really hard to say what's going to happen next, but I'm not worried about it at all because we've had such a beautiful history together.
If it was all taken away tomorrow, we'd feel pretty good about what we've done so far. And if they said, your band's over, we'd be okay. But I don't know, we're having too much fun, so I can't imagine stopping after this.
Meet the new queen of hip-hop soul. Mary J. Blige Behind the Music is next, part of a VH1 Diva Marathon.
Porno. Someone said porno. What? What does that mean, Tony?
Porno? It's like when it's adult movies. They have people have sex on the screen. They film it, and then people get off on it. You should watch them. They're good.
It's strange when you have a camera at the end of the night like this, where we're all euphoric and having a good time.